This is, well, you know what I'm going to say next. Natv Network. And, well, you've kind of asked us to put these ingredients together over the past 2.5 years. We have been slow walking it, and today is our chance to debut this pilot show to you. So we're going to give you some tips and tools in dealing with a narcissist. We hope that it can be beneficial to you. We have a number of things in store for you for this type of format. You told us that you got tired of seeing two people just Zoom talking and a number of things that you've seen on other platforms. We have taken, again, all the ingredients you've given us, put them in a huge bowl, mixed it all around, and, well, here we are keeping our word. This is NATV Network, home of NATV YouTube podcasts and, well, NATV radio. First thing up, you've told us that you've been struggling in dealing with a narcissist. One of the main things is forgiving yourself. Please keep this in mind. You're not crazy, first of all. And secondly, you're not alone. And by all means, remember number three, it's not your fault. With that in mind, forgiving yourself can be a challenge. One step in recovering is making sure to forgive yourself, that you allowed someone to come into your world that you trusted and they were not honest. Now, it may sound easy to say forgive yourself, and many are struggling with that, but by all means, practice accepting the past. It can be really hard to accept the past. It can be very challenging. But as you stand in the present, you're going to need to use your mental energy in a different way. It's easy to spend our mental energy blaming someone else, blaming the self-absorbed person, the narcissist, and blaming others, making ourselves the victim. But by all means, you can rise above it. You can maneuver around it. You can even plow straight through it. One of the ways that can be of a great assistance to you is keeping a feelings log, making sure that you're keeping track of your emotions, not allowing them to stay in the past as you move forward toward the future. Holding on to the present, keeping that feelings log, staying close to others who truly care for you. Get in touch with your strengths again. What is it exactly you like to do? Not sure? Talk to friends and family. Reacquaint yourself with yourself. You may feel inadequate at times, but this is something you can navigate and move through. Consider doing a little self-esteem exercise every day, maybe for the next 30 days or so. Consider this. Listen to NATV radio. Did you like that? I had to stick that plug in there. Thank you for being here for this pilot show. We've got tons of other tips for you, so hang in there. Tell me, what is it about you that you've been able to accomplish since finding out that you were dealing with a narcissist? Put that information in the comments, share it with the NATV community, continue to strengthen one another in this process. Please remember to keep this tip in mind. Respect your body. Take care of yourself. Drink more water. Get at least 20 minutes of exercise. Hold on to getting a good night's sleep. Challenging as these things may be, as you move toward making them a routine where you're focusing on your health and your time, amazing, those steps will become easier. When it comes to the narcissist, there are many frustrations that can come along the way. But when you make it about yourself and your recovery, it's amazing how the fears can subside and your desires for a peaceful home and life and family will start to pull themselves together. What a narcissist does at the end of a relationship exposes their true colors, being a self-absorbed and entitled person who lacks empathy. As you navigate away from that type of a person, trauma bonding can truly be challenging. Trauma bonding means that you stay connected to someone who is hurting you badly. How do you move away from that? By rejecting what the narcissist is doing, not participating in the games that they play. In their own sick little minds, they make sure to let you know no one leaves them. And of course, the turning of the tables may happen, but that's when the tip of using no contact, minimum contact, or non-emotional conversations can prove beneficial to you. A narcissist will use your past against you just to mess with your head. But without a doubt, you have tools and tips that can be helpful because you know not to play the game anymore. We have plenty more to share with you that you've given us here at NATV Network. But one thing is for sure, you've made it through, many of you. You've made it through the process. Make sure to help others. We hope that by validating your experience and by giving you some perspective on your situation, you'll be able to take tangible advice that you've received and pass it on to others. Thank you for allowing us to spend time with you today. Our shows will, of course, be longer, and some of them will be, well, about this length. And we will have guests and many more things that you've told us you wanted to have on a radio show. Narcissistic abuse and a whole lot more. Thank you for spending time with us today. Enjoy the music on the way out.
Dreaming. You could scream and shout, cry a thousand tears, and I wouldn't let fear win.